After months of tension between Metro Police and the Community Oversight Board, a new agreement between the two groups shows new signs of hope. But does the agreement still have the board give the board enough power to do its job? News Channel 5's Jason Lim spoke with the head of the COB tonight, who says she's more optimistic than ever.
The new agreement between the city's Community Oversight Board and Metro Police outlines how the groups will interact with each other.
I think we've made a tremendous amount of progress.
After a contentious few months, the chair of the Community Oversight Board sounds more optimistic than ever.
I'm overjoyed, I'll tell you what, because when I think back about 4 to 6 months ago, this seemed like a daunting task that many were thinking might be too big for Nashville. Well, there's nothing too big for Nashville when we talk about collaboration, especially when we have partners like Metro Police at the table. And I'm really thankful for their involvement.
Both police and the Oversight Board made concessions in the compromise. Board members will get crime scene access in some cases, but Metro Police are only encouraged to cooperate, not required to, with any Community Oversight Board investigation. The board chair says she thinks that encouragement of cooperation will be enough.
But it does give you the essence of knowing that the spirit is saying that there's been an agreement that they would. We have every reason to believe that that will be the case, and the community of Nashville should know that.
That confidence seems to be felt in other areas of the city government as well. Metro Councilman Russ Pulley is the head of the council's Public Safety Committee.
Once you start getting these things up and running and working like they should be working, I'm very hopeful that a lot of people's worries will be put to rest.
The board chair says Metro Police and the Community Oversight Board are too often thought to be in opposition. She says this memo and what she says is vastly improved communication between the two groups suggests otherwise.
You know, I'm a 9-10 generation Nashvillian, and I don't think any of my ancestors would have thought something like this would have existed, so I'm thankful.
Jason Lamb, News Channel 5.